ओके, मैग्नेटिज्म लेसन 3, इट इज अ थ्योरी डेरिवेशन. व्हाट विल बी फाइंडिंग आउट द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बी ऑन द एक्सियल लाइन ऑफ ए बार मैग्नेट. एज यू कैन सी फ्रॉम हियर देर इज अ बार मैग्नेट. लुक एट दिस. दिस इज द बार मैग्नेट. दिस इज द साउथ पोल ऑफ द मैग्नेट. दिस इज द नॉर्थ पोल ऑफ द मैग्नेट. सो दिस डॉटेड लाइन इज द एक्सियल लाइन. And the magnetic length of the magnet, that is from the south to north, is L plus L, that is 2L. You can take it X also. And O is the midpoint. And here is a point P on the axial line where we have to find out the magnetic field due to the bar magnet. And there will be two fields. Means if you put a north pole here, unit north pole here, that north pole will be repelled by this north pole to this side. That will be called B1, magnetic field B1. And this unit north pole will be attracted by this south pole towards this side. That will be called B2. And the distance from O to the point P, I have taken it as R, right? So a similar derivation we had done in electrostatics when we had found out the electric field intensity or the electric field on the axial line of an electric dipole. Let me slightly enlarge it so that you are able to see the diagram properly. Then I come back to the same position. Okay, it's now, I think it's clear. So now look at the discussion. Very, very simple. It will hardly take 6-7 minutes. Now look, the magnetic field B on the axial line of a bar magnet. Let NS, from N to S or from S to N, you may write as NS or you may write as SN, is a bar magnet. As we know, a magnet, it has always two poles, a north pole and south pole, and both the poles always have the same strength, the pole strength. Let small m is equal to the pole strength of each pole, means this is the pole strength of the south pole, and m is also pole strength of the north pole. And the distance between S and N, that is the magnetic length, let it be 2L. Why I have taken it 2L? Because if you consider the midpoint, from this point to this point will be L, from this point to this point will be L. Means I don't want to take it as a fraction. Means if I consider the length from S to N as L, then from here to here will be L by 2. That is a fraction. I'm trying to stay away from the fractions, but the final expression will be same. But whatever you take it, take the length as, whether you take it 2L or whether you take it as L or whether you take it as X, the final expression will remain same. Now, as I just explained, P is a point on the axial line. Here is the point P on the axial line, and its distance from the center of the magnet is R. P is a point on the axial line at a distance R from O, which is the center of the bar magnet, where the magnetic field is to be calculated. So, since O is the midpoint, therefore, SO is equal to ON is equal to L, since O is the midpoint of 2L, that is the midpoint of the magnetic length. Now, therefore, distance of this point P from the north pole will be R minus L, and distance of the point P from the south pole will be R plus L. So R plus L. Now, whenever you are required to find the magnetic field due to a bar magnet at a point, Keep a unit north pole here. Unit north pole means whose pole strength is equal to 1. And then find out what is the total force on it due to the north pole and due to the south pole. The moment you keep a unit north pole, instead of saying force, you say field, right? So now keep a unit north pole at point P, means a pole of pole strength 1 unity is kept at point P. Now, from Coulomb's law in magnetism, we know force between two pole strengths of M1 and M2 was derived as mu naught by 4 pi M1 M2 over R square. This was Coulomb's law in magnetism, which I explained in lesson 1. Therefore, the magnetic field at P due to the north pole only, between the north pole and the point P, the distance is R minus L. So, a unit north pole is kept at P. So, the magnetic field, because a unit north pole is kept at P, now instead of saying the force F, I will use the expression magnetic field and I'll use the symbol B. So, the magnetic field at P due to the north pole is, using this expression, let it be B1, will be mu naught by 4 pi, pole strength of the north pole. Pole strength of the unit north pole, that is unity, divided by square of the distance. So that comes out to be mu naught by 4 pi m over r minus l whole square along px. Why along px? A unit north pole is kept here. This is the north pole. Two identical poles, they repel. So this north pole is repelling this unit north pole to this side along px. So your B1 is along px. Similarly, the magnetic field at point P due to the south pole is, using the same expression, let it be B2 will be mu naught over 4 pi, pole strength of the south pole multiplied by pole strength of the unit north pole, which I have taken it as 1, divided by square of the distance, SP. So that comes out to be mu naught over 4 pi m over r plus l whole square along PS, because this unit north pole will be attracted to this side. Now look at these two expressions. Look at the value of B1 and look at the value of B2. Here the numerator is less. Here the denominator is less. Here the denominator is more. Therefore, the magnitude of B1 is greater than the magnitude of B2. Means magnitude of B1 is greater than B2. Means B1 is more and B2 is less. So the net field will be B1 minus B2 and it will be to this side. It will be to this side along PX. So let us go to the next phase. That's what I am explaining here. The magnitude of B1 is greater than the magnitude of B2. Therefore, the net field is B1 minus B2 and it will be along PX, means along the direction of B1, means along the direction of the magnetic moment M. So the net field at P is B, let it be B, will be B1 minus B2. The direction I have already explained. Here I am finding out the magnitude. What will be the magnitude? So B1 minus B2. Mu naught by 4 pi m is taken common, so I am left with 1 by r minus l whole square minus 1 by r plus l square. This I can rewrite it as 1 by r minus l whole square minus 1 by r plus l whole square. Square of 1 is 1, square of this is this, square of 1 is 1, square of r plus l is r plus l square. Now this comes under the algebraic expression A square minus B square. So which will be A plus B into A minus B. If you consider this as A and this as B, then this comes under the algebraic expression A square minus B square, that is equal to A plus B into A minus B, an identity in algebra. So that is what I have done here. So is equal to A plus B times A minus B. This was already taken common. It is still there. So I take the LCM. It is again a plus b into a minus b, so a square minus b square. So all this is the numerator. Similarly, here it is also a plus b into a minus b, that is a square minus b square. So this is the numerator. Here LL cancels, here RR cancels. So here I am left with 2R and here I am left with 2L. So mu naught over 4 pi m, which was taken common previously. So 2R into 2L over R square minus L square into R square minus L square. So R square minus L square whole square. Now I keep this m with this 2L. So 2ml. This 2R remains as same. So this is the denominator. Now what was this? In magnetism 2, I had explained this is a vector quantity called magnetic moment. It was defined as the pole strength multiplied by the magnetic length. It is a vector quantity directed from south pole to north pole. So for this, I can now substitute capital M, that is the magnetic moment. So your B is equal to mu naught over 4 pi M into 2R, 2MR over R square plus L square, square from that, and it is along PX, where M is called the magnetic moment. It is a vector quantity, which I explained in lesson 2. Now, so what is the conclusion for a point on the axial line? B and M are in the same direction. That is, the net field is from south to north, and the magnetic moment is also from the south to north, so they are in the same direction. Now, if the magnet length is very, very small, a similar thing also we had derived in electrostatics. If the bar magnet is very small, means 2L is very, very less, 2L is very, very less than R, which implies L is very, very less than R. Means the point of consideration, the point means the point where the point P where we are finding out the magnetic field, its distance from OR is R is much larger than the length of the magnet. In that case, means a short bar magnet. Means if the bar magnet is very small, L is very, very less than R. So L can be neglected with respect to R. So by neglecting L from this expression, the final expression, L is neglected, R squared square, so R to the power 4. So we are left with R to the power 4, 1 R cancels, R cube. So for a short bar magnet, small bar magnet, magnetic field on the axial line is mu naught over 4 pi, 2m over R cube. This is a constant, 2 is a constant, m is a constant for a given magnet. So B is proportional to 1 over R cube. And it is along PX. A similar expression we had derived in electrostatics also. And what was that? To find the electric dipole, to find the electric field on the axial line of an electric dipole and also for a short dipole. Right. Thank you.